ओम ब्रह्मानंदम परम सुखदम केवलम ज्ञानमूर्तिम द्वंद्वातीतम त्रिगुणरहितम तस्मस्यादिलक्ष्यम एकम नित्यम विमलमचलम सर्वदेशाक्षीहुतम भावातीतम गगनसदृशम सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। ओम गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। ध्यानमूलं गुरुमूर्ति पूजामूलं गुरुपदम् मंत्रमूलं गुरुर्वाक्यं मोक्षमूलं गुरुकृपा। सद्गुरु भगवान की जय। स्वामी जी महाराज की जय। शिवोहम। वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द 29th स्टेंजा ऑफ चैप्टर 10। सद्गुरु सच्चिदानंद परमात्मा is telling about his omnipresence and he is telling about the cause of life. Yachapi sarvabhutanam bijam tad aham arjuna na tadasti vinayasya यत्स्यान्मयाभूतं चराचरं यत्चापि सर्वभूतानां बीजं तत् अहम् अर्जुन न तत् अस्ति विना यत्स्यात्मयाभूतं चराचरं च इट मीन्स एंड अर्जुन इट मीन्स डियर अर्जुन यत् इट मीन्स दोज सर्वभूतानाम ऑल द लिविंग एंड नॉन लिविंग बीइंग्स बीजम इट मीन्स रूट कॉज तथा इट मीन्स दैट अपि इट मीन्स आल्सो अहम इट मीन्स आई एम बिकॉज तत् इट मीन्स दैट चराचरम इट मीन्स लिविंग एंड नॉन लिविंग्स भूतम इट मीन्स भूत Na is it means not. Asti it means is. Yata it means that. Maya it means from me. Vina it means without. Syat it means is. My dear Arjun, and I am the root cause of living and non-living beings because that and there is no any bhuta without me. Sadguru Sachidananda Paramatma, the only and only base and installation of universes and galaxies. Sadguru Sachidananda Paramatma, the master of millions and countable galaxies is talking to the Arjuna, the last and very very great central knowledge about him. He is telling to Arjuna, Arjuna, my Partha, those all livings and non-living beings, as you see in this world, I am the root cause of these things' origin. Because I am only the consciousness in this world. Because the consciousness is the portion of the life. So I am only the one life in this world. The one life divided in many, many parts. Many, many living beings, as one sun seems in many, many mirrors. So my dear friend Arjuna, then and there, everything, every living beings or non-living beings, because the trees are living beings, but they are not movable. So movable or non-movable, all are originated by me because my para and apara nature create all this world. But even you are alive or non-alive, stone also having the Atma, stone also having the existence. The existence not only knows the living beings, but existence also knows the non-living beings because the existence have their also. I remember a story. When the Buddha was living in Kapilvastu, and his disciple was went to the market for any work. When he returned, he come very late. Buddha asked him, "Why you come late?" Then Buddha told, "Why you come late?" When his disciple Anand told, "I am late because I was seeing the game of princess. The prince are playing a game. That game was played on the riders of the horse, the back of the horse. And they have a stick and they have a ball and they are going, doing goal and playing the game. So, what happened?" The Anand says that the persons they are playing, they are tired and they sleep. They stop the game. So Buddha asked, "Only person tired? The horses were not tired?" Anand said, "Yes, horses were also tired." Then Buddha asked, "Only the person in the horses were tired? The ball was not tired? The poles was not tired?" The Anand was very amazing. How can ball tired and how can the pole tired? Anand give nothing, no answer, and he went for the rest in night. And all the night he was thinking how the ball will tire, how the pole will tire. In the morning, the answer came and he ran to the Buddha. Buddha was doing meditation and put his head in the feet of Buddha and say, "Master, the ball also tired and the poles also tired." Buddha put his hand on his head and say, "You are right, because the existence is also living in ball and poles also. So the consciousness only seeing in living beings, but you can't see the consciousness in the non-living beings, but there is also consciousness, but that consciousness is unmeasurable, unknowing, known consciousness, because that is existence existing there also, but you have no ability to know that consciousness." So my dear friend, the same thing as Buddha teaches to Ananda, same thing is telling here Lord Krishna to the Arjuna. Lord Krishna is telling to Arjuna, "My dear Arjuna, I am the root cause, I am the basic cause, of all living and non-living beings, sarva bhutanam, because bhuta is not only jiva, bhuta is panch mahabhuta, they are also bhuta. The fire, the earth, the water, the air, they are also bhuta. So the deep meaning of this stanza, nobody can understand without the help of the Master Sadguru. So, the Krishna is telling to Arjuna that all living beings, they can arisen only by me. Because the all living beings or non-living beings, all bhutas, they are originated by the para and apara nature. But directly or indirectly, the root cause of the origination is only existence. Because the microest presence in all, I am there. I know everyone, but nobody knows me. Existence even knows in every living beings or non-living beings, but they do not know to existence because they are all without any consciousness. Because consciousness only comes from existence. Consciousness cannot come by the water or fire or earth. No. Consciousness only comes from existence. So, my dear friend, in the many religious books of this world, they are telling same thing. But I want to say here, the central concept of every religion is the same. It is very, very similar to the Upanishads. But peripheral structure of the religions, they are depend on their place and time and condition. So the religion of this world only one, that is knowing your Atma, knowing your consciousness. Because if you sleep in the night, you do not know in the stage of the sleeping that you are man or woman even. You do not know even you are poor or rich. You do not know what is your nationality, what is your caste, what is your creed, what is your skin color. Nobody knows. It proof. The sleep is the biggest proof. It proof that we are all one. Because the sleep wash out your every identity. The sleep, there is no dream. The sound sleep is declare that you are nothing, only consciousness is. Because after awakening the sleeping, you know that you sleep very well. So my dear friends, the Krishna is telling a practical thing. We can prove it. We can prove it. The sleep can wash out your all the efforts of your all the day, and death can wash out your all the effort of your all the life. So the religion is one, religion is awakened. Religion is one, religion is know yourself inside. That is the source of the real extreme divine love. The sex is not love. The eating is not love. The giving present each other is not love. The hugging is not love. The kissing is not love. The real love is awaken yourself. So the we are the persons tell a similar thing. We are the same love and same light, but they do not know what is the love and what is the light. When the sun rises, the light comes. When a person awaken, the love is come. When a person awaken, before awaken the person, when he do the meditation, the peace comes firstly. The satisfaction comes secondly. I told my disciples, I do not need anything. I do not need money, I do not need gift, I do not need anything. I am satisfied. I have enough. But this is showing that I am satisfied. I do not need anything. I can live without cloth. I can live without ashram. I do not need even a piece of cloth. I can hide my shameful organs by the leaves. But I do not compromise with fake thing. I do not compromise with untrue, false. I do not give you the blindness knowledge of blindness. I only give you the truth. I only give you the extreme knowledge of liberation. You know, the enlightened persons, they are not compromised, they are not adjust, so they need like a egoistic person, so they see like a egoistic person, so they misguided by the behavior of enlightened person, because they do not care. They say the truth as a surgeon. They are the spiritual doctors. They are the spiritual masters. They want to give you the ultimate peace. They do not want to give you the temporary peace. They are not massager. They want to give you the permanent peace and permanent pleasure and permanent happiness. That happiness is not coming by the physical body. The happiness is coming from the deep circle of your soul. This light is coming, not coming from the sun. This light is coming from existence. So the God is telling appropriately, because He is omnipresence. When the God is omnipresence, the peace is omnipresence, the light is omnipresence, the knowledge is omnipresence, the love is omnipresence, then how can not you enjoy that love? How can you are so sad? How can you are so worried? How can you are so tension? If the God is in you, you must be happy, you must be pleasant, you must be prosperous, you must be enjoy your internal state of the energy. So my dear friend, this is the seed in you, that is existence. So that is presence even in the trees, in the fisheries, in the reptiles, in the birds, in the mammals, in the insect, in the arthropods, everywhere. So the God is the basic root cause of this creation. God is the basic root cause of liberation also. The God is the basic root cause of living and non-living. And God is the basic root cause of movable or non-movable creatures. So, my dear friends, so the God is telling, nothing, nobody is without me. Nobody can stand here without existence. Because no cloth can be weaved without the thread. Earth cannot be made by the without the atoms or molecules. So how can possible this creation without the God? So my dear friend, you know, the God knows everyone, and no one can know the God without the help of the enlightened master, enlightened Sadguru. When the enlightened Sadguru teach his disciple a special technique of the meditation, in this world, the person they are teaching the fake meditation. That is not a meditation, that is a concentration. This chakra, that chakra, that chakra, that chakra, this experience, that experience. No, that is not meditation. The real meditation is the meditation of awareness. There is no chanting, there is no mantra, there is no chakra, there is no experience. There is only and only witnessing, seeing and detachment. So I want to say, my dear friend, that even you do not know how to lives come in the sperms and the ovums and how to the fertilizations come in your life. Told me when your fertilization came, when there was, you are the small egg in the womb of your mother and your father is sperm stuck there and both are fusion and become the fertilization and you are become the embryo. But you do not know, you do not can tell, because your consciousness is not so keen or aware. If you want to make your consciousness so keen and aware, then you can detach from all illusion of the Maya. You can detach from physical, mental and causal body. If you want to feel the real peace and real love and real light and real consciousness of the life, please come to me. I will teach you the real meditation, and it is very good news for you. In the 1st August 2015, we are organizing a meditation camp in New Delhi. And if you want to register yourself in that camp, you can see the Facebook wall of Satyabodh Premananda or Facebook wall of Swami Vedantananda. I want to most welcome you and I want to invite you in that camp. Thank you very much, my dear. Love you very much.